prelude to an epic operation by the RAF. 18 Mosquitos of the 2nd Tactical Air Force, including a squadron of the Royal Australian Air Force, carried out the task led by Group Captain Pickard of Target for Tonight fame. It was to prove his last flight. Persons, it has not been possible until now to give a full account of this exploit. In the words of the briefing officer, Mosquitos are to attack the prison at Amiens to assist more than 100 prisoners to escape. These prisoners are French patriots condemned to death for assisting the Allies. At briefing, the crews detailed for the task learned that the prison was not difficult to find. In order to deceive the Germans as to their destination, the aircraft swung north at a given point and flew to Doulon, where they turned south until they hit the main Albert-Amiens road. This road provided an excellent lead into the target, which lay just to the east of the town of Amiens. 0 hour was midday. At this time last February, the prisoners were to be released by the most welcome raid of the war. It was snowing hard as the aircraft flew out from England at 0 feet across the sea towards the French coast. They were picked up by their fighter escort of 2 Typhoons to each aircraft. So bad was the visibility that they had to fly almost wingtip to wingtip. Out over the channel, the snow stopped and the weather improved. Here is a model of the prison which the aircraft were on their way to attack. This was used for briefing the crew. At the back, you can see the Albert-Amiens Road, the guide to the target. At each extremity of the prison are the buildings believed to house the Nazi prison guards. The main buildings, in the form of a cross, housed the French patriots. The task of the first 12 aircraft was to breach the wall in 2 places and to destroy the buildings housing the Nazi prison guards. The remaining 6 aircraft were to bomb the prison out of existence should the first attack be a failure, in which case many of the condemned men might be killed by British bombs instead of Nazi bullets. They would at least have a chance to escape. And so to the target itself. You can see the fighters protecting the bombers fly across our path as we run up to the target. The aircraft carrying the cameras will take you over the target after the first 12 aircraft have bombed, and you'll be able to see how successful they have been. And here's the shot again, slowed down. There could be no doubt about the success of the attack. As the aircraft ran over the target, the pilot said he could see men running through a large hole where the wall had been breached. And inside the prison, he could see many others in brown dungarees running for the hole in the wall. The Nazi prison guard quarters are covered with smoke from bursting bombs, and the walls have been breached. With amazing skill, the bomb aimers have blown an exit in the main building. Perfect discrimination in this, one of the most difficult operations of the war. The walls are breached and hardly anything is left standing of the prison guard quarters. Although some of the patriots were killed by German machine guns as well as by bombs, a high percentage escaped. The Germans also suffered casualties from the attack. 2 of the fighter escort and 2 Mosquitos were lost. One of them, Group Captain Pickard. He died leading probably the most successful operation of his gallant and brilliant career. The breached walls were 20 feet high. Through the gaps, friends of the Allies made good their escape. Nearby rests the body of Group Captain Pickard, the young man who led his squadrons to brilliant success and made sure that the RAF had paid another debt. One of the Allied landing strips under construction. Bulldozers scoop. Bulldozers and rollers, plus the muscle power of Pioneer Corps and RAF servicing commandos, are... our frontline aircraft.